Wildfires in 2017 spewed so much smoke and ash into the atmosphere, it equaled the amount of a volcanic eruption. That according to the U.S. Naval Research Laboratory. They just presented a study on wildfire weather in hopes of understanding fire weather predictions better.
New tonight, CBS 13 meteorologist Lisa Meadows is live in Sacramento County to break down the study for us. Lisa?
That's right, Tony and Christina. Pyrocumulonimbus clouds. They're clouds that form on top of wildfires, and they can actually spew smoke all the way up to 60,000 feet, which is almost as much as stacking up 200 of these skyscrapers on top of each other. Now, we have a new study that came out with the results telling us a lot more about this wild weather. 2017 wildfires have wreaked havoc on the ground, but also in the air.
This is the first time that a wildfire event produced a similar amount of material in the stratosphere comparable to what a volcano would do.
This smoke can be a concern for planes flying at that height and also for the climate.
The smoke plume from that event ended up encircling the northern hemisphere over the course of about 4 months.
David Peterson, a meteorologist with the U.S. Naval Research Laboratory, has been studying wildfires of 2017, trying to help us better understand and predict wildfire weather and smoke in the atmosphere.
If we're putting material into the stratosphere the way a volcano does, do these fire-triggered thunderstorms have a role in the climate system?
And last year was a good fire year to study.
2017, as we well know, is unfortunately a record year for not only acreage, but destruction of homes, and unfortunately 46 fatalities with over 1.4 million acres burnt in California alone.
Some of those wildfires also created their own storms.
There's so much heat coming up off the fire that it creates its own weather system.
This study, along with more research in the future, may help us understand how smoke acts in the air and how wildfires produce storms below.
Understanding the meteorology, the weather that drives these events, is important so we can build a prediction in the future.
And we actually saw so much smoke in 2017 from this that UC Davis is right now working on a study. They're asking people who were impacted by that smoke to go online and fill out a survey.
Interesting study. All right, Lisa, thanks for that. To learn more about the UC Davis wildfire study and how you can take part, head to our website, cbs13.com. Curtis?